Hello everyone, welcome to the 13th part of this lecture. In this video, we are going to see about shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. So let's get started. And before we start, I would really appreciate it if you could smash that like button, drop me a comment and share this free program with anyone who might need it. The first question is, the bending moment distribution in a beam is shown in figure. What is the shear force? So since there is, you know, moment present at the ends of the both the sides, I can say that it is a fixed end beam. Only in fixed end beams you'll have moment at the ends. If it had been a cantilever, then you'll have moment only here, and if it had been a simply supported beam, you'll not have any moments at the ends. So since it has moments, I can say it is a fixed end beam. So coming to the type of bending moment present here, I know that for a point load acting in a simply supported beam, it will be something like this. So I can say that it will be something like this. And for the fixed end moments, my moment will be something like this. So this will be a negative moment, this will be a positive moment. So these both will be, you know, superimposed for a fixed end beam having a point load in the middle. So I can say that this is the beam diagram for this given bending moment diagram. So let me draw the shear force diagram here. So what will be my shear force? It will be simply, it will be I'll have my reactions here RA, RB. So it will be simply like this. So this is my shear force diagram for the given beam. So the answer is option A. Next question. The simply supported beam is loaded as shown in figure. The maximum shear force in the beam will be what? So let me, since it is a simply supported beam, let me find RA and RB. So I can say that RA and RB will be equal because the loading is symmetrical. So it will be total load divided by 2. My total load is W plus 2W plus W by 2. So it is 4W by 2, which is 2W. So this is my RA and RB value. So if I draw the shear force diagram, this is 2. Yes, just by looking at this diagram itself, you can say what is my maximum shear force diagram. I can say that it is 2W, but in case you are not that well versed, then you can go with the conventional way. So the maximum shear force is 2W. The answer is 2W. You can just, in a simply supported beam, if they ask for the maximum shear force, it will be mostly at the ends only. Therefore, you can just simply choose your reactions at the ends. That will be your answer for maximum shear force. Next question. The shape of the bending moment diagram for a cantilever beam carrying a uniformly distributed load is what? This is my cantilever beam. It has a uniformly distributed load. What is the shape of the bending moment diagram? It will be like this. Since it is a UDL, it will be in the shape of a parabola. But in case you don't know how to find whether it can be a parabola or a hyperbola, in case you're confused, then just write the bending moment for this. So what will be the bending moment? This is W, this is L. The bending moment will be W into length into central distance, L by 2. So this is W L square by 2. So you can see that the power of L is 2. So if it is 2, it is parabola. If it had been just L, that is, if the power had been 1, it is a straight line. If the power has been 3, it is a hyperbola, and so on. So for this answer, for this question, the answer is option B, which is parabola. Next question. The simply supported beam is subjected to a distributed loading as shown in the diagram. The maximum shear force is what? So I have already told you, if it is a simply supported beam, the maximum shear force will act at the ends only. So I just have to find the RA and RB value, that is the reactions. So RA, RB will be equal because the loading is symmetrical. It will be total load divided by 2. So what? This is my maximum shear force. The answer is option A. Next question. The point of counterflexure is a point where what? So what is point of counterflexure first of all? Let me take a propped cantilever beam. So this is a fixed end. Therefore, I'll have moment here. Whereas this is a simply supported end that is a hinged. Therefore, I'll not have any moment here. So my bending moment diagram will be something like this. And this point, right, the point where the bending moment is zero is called as my point of counterflexure. So this is what we tell. The point of counterflexure is where bending moment is zero. So with that in mind, let us come to the options given. bending moment changes its sign. Yeah, this is correct, because from here we can say that from positive to negative it has changed, or vice versa. So that is your answer. Point of counterflexure is where bending moment changes its sign and not the shear force. But to the next question, the ratio of the reaction A and B of the simply supported beam is what? So we have to find RA and RB. So let me find RA first. which is equal to 6. So RA is equal to 6 tons. I have found. I have to find what is RB. So RB is equal to total load minus RA. I can just do that. So what is my total load? Which is equal to 12. So my total load is 12. Therefore RB is equal to 12 minus 6, which is equal to 6. So if I find RA by RB, it is equal to 6 by 6, therefore the ratio is 1. The answer is option C. Next question, the bending moment in a simply supported beam can be calculated with the help of influence line diagram for the following types of load. So what types of load it can be used? So this is my simply supported beam. I can use the point load, therefore yes, I can use option A. I can also use, you know, distributed load, UDL, yes, I can use. And I can use n number of point loads also. So option C is also correct. Therefore, I have to choose all the above three is my answer. Next question. A simply supported beam of length L with a triangular load varying from 0 to 0 at one end to the maximum value at the other end. Okay, the maximum bending moment is what? So this is my simply supported beam. This is how they have told, 0 at one end and maximum at other end. So they asked what is the maximum bending moment. So in the previous video we saw where the maximum bending moment occurs, that is for a loading something like this where shear force is 0. So when shear force is 0, bending moment will be maximum. We saw where it will be 0. It will be 0 at L is equal to L by root 3. So we have seen that. In case you don't remember it, it's okay. We will derive the answer from the basics itself. So in the previous video itself we saw, in order to find RA, I can just take 1/3 of the total load. So I have to find what is my bending moment. So I'm going to assume that it occurs at, it is the maximum bending moment, it occurs at a distance of x. So I'm going to find the bending moment at x. It is equal to RA into x minus load due to this point. So for x, what will be my intensity? My intensity will be W into x by L will be my intensity for a distance of x. So for this, RA into x minus half into the length is x into height is x into W by L into distance is x by 3. So this is my answer. So from this I have to find the bending moment. So RA, I already know it is WL by 6. Therefore this becomes, I know that when shear force is equal to 0, my bending moment is maximum. So in order to find where my shear force is equal to 0, I have to differentiate bending moment with respect to x and equate it to 0. From that I will get a value of x, and at that place only my shear force will be 0. So when I differentiate my bending moment with respect to x, what will I get? This will become WLX by 6 will become just WL by 6 minus this will become 3WX square by 6L. So from this I have to find what is my value of X. I'm going to take it to 0, right? So this will become for X is equal to L by root 3. So we saw this at a value of L by root 3, our shear force will be 0 in the first sum in the previous lecture itself. So if you have that in mind, then you can just skip all these, you know, all these steps and go directly to the next step. So we know that at the distance of x equal to L by root 3, our bending moment will be maximum. This is my XL, and I know that x equal to L by root 3, my shear force, I mean the bending moment will be maximum. So I'm going to substitute this value here. WL square divided by 9 root 3. So the answer is option D. Going to the next question. For a simply supported beam of length L, and the maximum bending moment is described as so and so. So they have already given the bending moment equation themselves. It is equal to x minus x cube by L square into A, where A is a constant. So shear force will be zero at which point? So they have given the bending moment equation. So we know that when we differentiate bending moment with respect to x, our shear force will be zero. So I'm going to just differentiate this equation with respect to x. When I is equal to L divided by root 3. So the answer is option C. Next question, match list 1 with list 2 and select the correct answer using the codes given below. So when you look at this for questions like this, if you know the bending moment diagram for complex structures like this, then go ahead. Otherwise, use these codes to your advantage. Okay, you know what is the bending moment for a cantilever beam carrying UDL. It is WL square by 2. So B is matched with 3. So this has 3, this has 3. So other things can be eliminated. So just ignore them. Then you know that for a simply supported beam carrying a UDL, it is WL square by 8. So for D, it is 4. So only this has 4, this has 4. This is already eliminated. Therefore, my answer is option A. So with this, we come to the end of the video. I hope you found this useful. If you did, please do give it a like and share it to your friends. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.